नमस्कार। नाउ वी विल डिस्कस द डीजेनरेसी ऑफ क्वांटम स्टेट। नाउ वी हैव डिस्कस दैट इफ द पार्टिकल इज ट्रैप्ड इन वन डायमेंशनल इनफाइनाइट पोटेंशियल वेल, दैट इज फ्रॉम एक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो टू एक्स इज इक्वल टू एल, देन देर इज क्वांटाइजेशन ऑफ द रीजन वेयर the particle can exist. That means there is formation of probability zone and there are discrete energy levels. Now those states of particle in which the particle exists, energy state, or we can say that it is the wave function, it is known as the state of particle. It is quantum state of particle. That means the particle may be in first quantum state with n is equal to 1, second quantum state with n is equal to 2, and so on. Now suppose if we think about the extension of this situation, that means if the particle is to be there in a plane, say for example, therefore I will represent that this is xy plane and particle is allowed to travel anywhere within this region, suppose from x is equal to 0 to x is equal to L, and from y is equal to 0 to, say for example, y is equal to b. That means within this region v is equal to 0 and outside this region v is equal to infinity. That means particle is confined to move in a plane, certain rectangle, say for example 0 to L and 0 to b, that is the rectangle of length L and breadth b. This is one more possibility. The other and most general possibility is that the particle is trapped or particle is confined to move in a box. Therefore, we will have to think about the particle trapped in three-dimensional potential box. That means it can move anywhere from x is equal to 0 to x is equal to L, anywhere from y is equal to 0 to y is equal to b, and anywhere from z is equal to 0 to z is equal to h. That means there is a box of dimensions L, B and h, and the particle can travel anywhere inside the box. And therefore, what I can say, inside the box V is equal to 0 and outside the box V is equal to infinity. That means this is the situation where the particle is confined to move within a rectangular box of length L, breadth B and height H. Okay. Now this situation is similar to the particle trapped in one dimensional infinite potential well. It is similar. Why? Because for every direction along X axis, it looks like the one dimensional potential well. Along Y axis, one dimensional potential well of width B, and along Z axis, one dimensional potential well of height z. But now as the particle is free to move in space, our equation, instead of writing d square by dx square, now I will have to extend this Schrodinger wave equation for three dimension, and I can write it is d square by dx square plus d square by dy square plus d square by dz square. Now that is to be operate on the wave function psi. Now that is a function of x, y and z, all the three, plus I will write it is twice m upon h cross square, then it is e minus v operated on wave function psi, that is a function of x, y, z, and that is equal to 0. Now remember that this is the del square operator. This is del square operator. That means the general form of Schrodinger time independent wave equation is del square psi plus twice m upon h cross square e minus v psi is equal to 0. Now here in case of one dimension, del square can be written as d square by dx square, but in three dimension Cartesian coordinate system, remember that this is important, in Cartesian coordinate system it is d square by dx square plus d square by dy square plus d square by dz square. Now here I would like to mention that in case of the electron, when it is revolving around the nucleus, we cannot use the Cartesian coordinate system, and at that time we will have to think about the polar coordinate system. And therefore last year we had observed the formula for del square operator, that is Laplacian operator for Cartesian coordinate system, polar coordinate system and cylindrical coordinate system too. Now if we will have to think about the Schrodinger wave equation for the electron in an atom, then same equation is to be used. The Schrodinger wave equation is same, only we will have to replace this del square operator from Cartesian coordinate to the polar coordinate, because the electron, when it is in an atom, there is a point symmetry. It is symmetric about the point, that is symmetric about the nucleus. Okay. Now, in this case, we will have to discuss with this. One more physical situation is such that all the three axes are independent. That means when the electron is traveling along x-axis, there is no role of y-coordinate or y-way, position along y-axis, position along z-axis. And hence, we can think about the wave function psi, which is a function of x, y, z, is made up of three independent wave functions. Capital X is a function of x, capital Y is a function of y, and capital Z is a function of z. See, this is an assumption based on the physical situation. Remember that all the three axes, x, y, z axis, are mutually independent. It may happen that for any value of y, the particle can travel from 0 to L along x-axis. There is no dependency on the value of x based on the value of y, or value of z based on the value of x, etc. And therefore, this assumption is the assumption based on the physical situation, that is based on physics. That means the wave function associated with a real particle in three dimension is the combination of three independent wave functions, x as a function of x, y as a function of y, and z as a function of z. Now, similar assumption was made by us while considering the wave function small psi as a function of x and t, where x is the representative position coordinate, that can be written as psi as a function of x into phi as a function of t. Again, this is the time independent part and this is the time dependent parts. In a similar manner, here we can think about the wave function psi to be x, y and z. Now in general, I can write psi is equal to x, y, z. Now when I represent it capital X, obviously it is a function of small x, capital Y is a function of small y, z is a function of small z, and psi, capital psi, is a function of x, y, z in case of a particle in potential box. Okay. Now the things are mathematical. Therefore, if I substitute this psi somewhere here, then I can write it is d square by dx square plus d square by dy square plus d square by dz square operated on x, y, z plus it is twice m upon h cross square e minus v. But now if the particle is inside the potential box, then the potential is zero. Outside this, it is infinity, and probability of finding the particle outside the box is zero. It is exactly similar to the one-dimensional potential well, and hence I can write E to be equal to E only, E operated on x, y, z, that is equal to zero. Correct? Therefore, this is the wave equation associated with the particle in potential box. Now here, if I operate this operator, three parts of operator on x, y, z, then it is a bit simple. I can write it is y and z are constant because these x, y, z are independent. Therefore, y is a function of y only, capital Z is a function of z only. And therefore, while differentiating with respect to x, we will have to treat capital Y, capital Z to be constant. And I will have to write it is d square x by dx square plus while differentiating with respect to y, we will have to treat x and z to be constant. Therefore, x and z, then it is d square capital Y by dy square. Similarly, while differentiating with respect to z, x and y are constant. Therefore, x, y, then it is d square capital Z by dz square plus, I will write it is twice m upon h cross square e. Now, here I will have to consider one interesting situation. Now, we know that energy is not a vector term. It is basically a scalar term. Energy is scalar. But this is the total energy, which is made up of kinetic energy and potential energy. But the potential energy of the particle inside the potential box is zero. okay, inside the box is zero, and hence the total energy is only because of the kinetic energy. Now if I think about the kinetic energy, it is because of the velocity component along x axis, y axis and z axis. Therefore actually I can write the kinetic energy to be equal to half m v square. But how I can write v square? I can write this that it is half m vx square plus vy square plus vz square, where vx is the velocity along x axis, vy is the velocity along z axis, and vz is the velocity along, vy is the velocity along y axis, and vz is the velocity along z axis. It is nothing but a Pythagoras theorem. This indicates that this energy can be written as ke along x axis, ke because of y axis, and ke because of z axis. Remember that I cannot say that it is kinetic energy along x axis, because kinetic energy is not a vector term. But this is the component of kinetic energy, not a vector component, general component. It is part of energy because of the velocity along x axis. And hence I can say that it is the x component of energy, x contribution. Remember that it is not the vector component. And therefore, I can write the total energy, which is nothing but the kinetic energy in this case, is k is Ex plus Ey plus Ez. That means Ex is the energy due to the velocity component along x-axis, Ey is the energy due to the velocity component along y-axis, and Ez is the energy due to the velocity component along z-axis. Now when I think about the velocity component along x-axis, it is independent of velocity component along y and z axis, and hence I can say that there are three different independent components of velocity, independent component of velocity, hence the independent component of energy Ex, Ey, Ez. Ex is independent of Ey and Ez, Ey is independent of Ex, Ez, and Ez is independent of Ex, Ey, and so on. Now I will divide throughout by capital X, Y, Z, and hence I can write it is 1 upon capital X d square x by dx square plus 1 upon capital Y d square y capital Y by dy square plus 1 upon capital Z d square capital Z by dz square plus I will write it is twice m upon h cross square ex plus twice m upon h cross square ey plus twice m upon h cross square ez is equal to 0. Okay, now when I divide throughout by xyz, then this xyz gets cancelled and I can write the equation to be in this form. Now the rearranging terms, I can write 1 upon capital X d square capital X by dx square plus twice m upon h cross square ex plus 1 upon capital Y d square capital Y by dy square plus twice m upon h cross square ey plus, or into bracket it is plus 1 upon capital Z d square capital Z by dz square plus twice m upon h cross square ez, and that is equal to 0. See, just I have collected these terms together, this and this term, then this and this term, and then this term and this term I have collected together, this plus this I mention here, this plus this I mention here, this plus this I mention here. Now interesting thing is that these three are similar term. Therefore, if this is negative, this is also negative, and this is also negative, because they are similar. X, Y, Z are interchangeable. Okay. And hence, if some constant or some term A plus B plus C is equal to 0, then essentially A is equal to 0, B is equal to 0, and C is equal to 0 if they are similar. Laksha dhya. Kadhi kadhi apan mathematics madhe asa lihto ki x plus y is equal to 0. Yacha arth x is 0 and y 0 asa hot nahi. X may be 2 and y may be minus 2. But suppose x and y are similar, म्हणजे x positive असेल तर y पण positive असला पाहिजे. अशा केस मध्ये जर x plus y is equal to 0 असेल तर x पण 0 पाहिजे आणि y पण 0 पाहिजे. Similarly, this term must be independently 0, this must be independently, and therefore that word is very important. It is independently 0. Irrespective of this term, these two terms, this must be 0. Irrespective of these two, this must be 0. And irrespective of these two, this term must be 0. Okay, and hence the single Schrodinger wave equation for three dimension can be written in three equations as 1 upon capital X d square capital X by dx square plus twice m upon h cross square ex is equal to 0. Similarly, I can write 1 upon capital Y d square capital Y by dy square plus twice m upon h cross square ey is equal to 0. And similarly, I can write it is 1 upon capital Z d square capital Z by dz square plus twice m upon h cross square ez is equal to 0. Correct? That means the single differential equation associated with a particle in infinite potential box of length L, breadth B and height H can be split into three independent equations, one for x axis where the x can vary from 0 to L, other for y axis where y can vary from 0 to B, and third for z axis where z can vary from 0 to H. Now it is very simple. This equation is exactly similar to the Schrodinger wave equation for a particle trapped in infinite potential well. It is d square psi by dx square plus twice m upon h cross square e is equal to 0 if this psi is to the denominator, and therefore this equation can be rearranged by multiplying throughout by x. I can write it is d square capital X by dx square plus twice m upon h cross square ex capital X is equal to 0. Now you can say that instead of psi there is x. See, I can compare this equation with this. This d square psi by dx square plus twice m upon h cross square e psi is equal to 0. That means as if the particle is in one dimensional potential well along x axis, as if the particle is in one dimensional potential well along y axis, therefore I will have to write it is d square y by dx square plus twice m upon h cross square ey into capital Y is equal to 0, and as if the particle is simultaneously in one dimensional potential well along z axis with equation d square z by dz square plus twice m upon h cross square ez operated on z is equal to 0. For this, the dimensions are or the particle is free from 0 to L, this 0 to B, and this 0 to H. And we are aware about the solution of this equation. This equation leads to the quantization of energy Ex with a quantum number Nx such that it is pi square h cross square divided by 2m L square. I will have to write it is Nx square. Correct? We are aware about that. See, by substituting this equation, last time we had observed that there is a quantization of energy pi square h cross square divided by 2m L square into N. But now that N is associated with x axis only, and therefore I will treat it is nx. Correct? It is nx. Similarly, this energy is along x axis but it is quantized with nx, and hence I can write it is enx. That means this energy component, it is ex, but now there is a quantization, there are different energy state along x axis, and hence I will have to write it as enx. Okay. Similarly, I will have to write it is eny to be equal to pi square h cross square divided by 2m now b square, because along y axis the particle can travel anywhere from 0 to b, and it is b square into ny square. And similarly for z, I can write enz is equal to pi square h cross square divided by 2mh square nz square, such that the total energy E, which is En, is made up of Enx plus Eny plus Enz. Now, why I am mentioning En? Initially, I had mentioned that it is E only. But now I realize that it is quantized for different quantum state Nx. That is, Nx will vary from 1, 2, 3 and so on. Similarly, Ny will vary from 1, 2, 3 and so on. And Nz will vary from 1, 2, 3 and so on. The reason is quite simple. Here also, in case of one dimensional potential well, we had considered that KIL is equal to n pi, where n varies from 0, 1 to L, but we have excluded the value of n to be equal to 0, and we have accepted n to be vary from 1 to 3 and so on up to infinity. Treating or using the same conclusion or same result, here I can write the situation is something like this. And now, this is the interesting result. Hence, the total energy can be written as En is equal to, check, it is pi square h cross square divided by 2m into bracket. I will have to write nx square divided by l square plus ny square divided by b square plus nz square divided by h square. Correct? This is the energy of particle, correct, in infinite potential well. Fine. Now, with help of this energy, we will discuss later on what is the physical interpretation of this energy, why it leads to degeneracy of energy state. Nth energy state is there, En, nth energy state. But what are the different sub-states are there with the same energy? We will discuss later on. Okay. Now, similar to this energy, how can I write the wave function associated with particle? X can be written as. See, we are aware about the wave function associated with the particle. To be equal to, see, it is sine, that is A sine of n pi x upon L. But after the calculating the value of A, I can write sine to be equal to root of 2 upon L sine of n pi x upon L. But now instead of psi, there is x for first equation, and hence I can write x is equal to root 2 divided by L sine of nx pi x divided by L. Similarly, how can I write the value of y? Capital Y can be written as root 2 divided by B, because here L represents the boundary of existence of particle, 0 to L. Similarly, along y-axis, it is 0 to b. Therefore, root 2 divided by b, I will have to write it is sine of ny pi y divided by b. And I can write z to be equal to root 2 divided by h. Then I can write sine of nz pi z divided by h. Now, combining all these equations together, how can I write the wave function psi? Psi is the product of x, y, z. Therefore, it is root of 8 divided by LBH into sine of, check, I will have to write it as it is, nx pi x divided by L sine of ny pi y divided by B and sine of nz pi z divided by H. This is the wave function associated with a particle in three-dimensional potential box of length L, breadth B and height H. Okay. Therefore, now how to draw the wave function? What is the physical significance? Now in three dimension it is difficult to draw, but how to represent? What is the physical significance of wave function? What is the physical significance of such type of nx, ny, nz for same quantum state En? That we will discuss in next time. That means up to this point it was the mathematical part of the derivation, and now during the next lecture, next session, we will discuss the physical significance of this energy, how it leads to the degeneracy of energy state, and physical significance of this wave function, how it leads to the different probability zones for different state and substate. Okay, thank you.